Hello, and welcome to OLI episode 3. Thank you, Smidge. OLI episode 3, and here we go. Smidge is gonna do some drawing over there. He's been doing drawing all the time, and a little painting, and coloring in and stuff, and yeah, so. I'm in a very strange mood today. Oh, I think it's the painting ideas that's going through my head, going poof, poof. So, yesterday I did one like a sunsetty sort of sunset sunrise, and we've got another sunrise today because this morning I saw another awesome sky. So I thought I'd try and put that one down on canvas as well. And when I was looking, I was thinking, oh, that's got a Naples yellow look to it. So I thought Naples yellow, and then I mean the ground was quite bright really, but there wasn't much colour. It was sort of a similar colour to the greyish colour that I used yesterday, but a little brighter. So I'll try and do that. And then there was a tree, and then there was these weird cloud. But anyway, we'll do it and see how it looks. So I've got some in Naples yellow. Naples yellow. I do like Naples yellow. It's a nice colour. I'm gonna do this the way I normally paint. Instead of putting the paints on, I don't actually do that. I start like this. I'll just do the one paint and then I'll start adding paints. I left my brushes in water. I didn't bother washing them yesterday. And I was like, oh, I need to wash my brushes. So let's have a look at this Naples yellow. It's quite a light colour. So let's think about this horizon. It was about there. So that's where ours will be. Naples yellow went, it was sort of angled because of the way the cloud was. So I'm just putting pure Naples yellow on first, and then what I'll put on, and then I'll put some white on as well, just to brighten it. So yeah, it was something like that. Goes up like that to about there. Sort of going into my memory banks, thinking about it. I think it went up higher. I think it went more like that. Think that's about right. I think. Just reflecting the light. Might be better. Let's get a little bit of white. Wipe the paint off my brush, the excess paint. We'll go into this white, titanium white. And we'll make our light colour. So the light is at the base, down here. So when you're trying to create light areas, like I'm doing now, the only way this is going to look light is if you've got darker colours around it. So you can start off anyway, but for this one, what I want to do is I want to put my light in first, and then I can start playing with it afterwards, messing around. but you could put you in your dark first. But I think when you're doing something like this, it might be better to put your light first, because then this is the color you want to keep clean, I think. I want to keep this area clean, so I don't want to get a load of black and greys and stuff in there. So I want to keep this area at least quite light. I think it was something like that, that glow that I saw. You couldn't see any sun rays or anything like that. It was all smooth, if I remember. Using my memory. Use my soft brush just to smooth it over. Okay, there we go. That's that bit done. Now, the sky above was like a bluey greyish colour. I think I better use a different brush, or I could just wipe this off. I'm really liking this brush. A lot of people ask me what brushes I use, and I don't like to say because I use cheapy ones. I tend to use graduate ones, but this artist's oil brush. Really liking it. Winsor & Newton one. Probably should get more of these ones. Somehow I got paint all over my hand. So if you do get paint on your hand, don't forget to wipe it off quickly, otherwise you get paint everywhere. Okay, so blue. It's quite a light bluey grey as well. So I might just touch a little bit of black. Not too much. And I need some more white since we used it all. White, a bit of titanium white. Got on clouds and so on. Let's grey this white down a bit. Da 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 da, and add in the blue. And what we got? Let's just put some on and have a look. Might actually be the right colour. Think it was actually something like this, sort of a greyish bluey colour like that. There is a possibility of my eyes playing tricks on me early in the morning, and then my memory. Don't know how good my memory is. But this is about right anyway. So, what I'm painting really is the impression of what I saw. What I felt. Well, actually, I felt bloody tired. Because I got up early. And that sky, saw the beautiful sky, and it made my day much better. Because then I thought, oh, I've got a painting idea for later now. Because I'm kind of doing this on the fly to make it harder for myself. I didn't want to prepare loads of paintings beforehand, because then, I don't know, it'd be like I'm going through the motions a bit, and I don't want to do that. I wanted to do something different. Do something exciting, like this. When you're just doing paintings out your head, it's exciting, it's new. Each painting you do, it's a new challenge. And just putting some white in and my blue into this grey mixture, because the this cloud was greyish. So, let's have a look. Yeah, that's about right. I'm just gonna sort of dab. It's kind of broken up here, actually. You could see like areas, and it was like a weird angle. I always think to myself, I don't know why, I always think to myself when I see clouds that are like funny shapes, and I think, well, if I paint that, I bet no one will believe me that it was like that. And then you start thinking, oh, what cloud would people believe was there? Maybe I should make it look like that, but then you'd be lying. If this is how the cloud was, and it was, then that's how you should paint it. Rather than trying to do paint things exactly how you think they should be. Trees that should be a certain way, or clouds that you think, oh, they should look like this. Do them the way you saw them. You don't want to be doing just pictures that you think that's going to appeal to people. Because this way of using nature is your inspiration is a good thing. It can make you develop paintings that no one else has done. Because a lot of people will be thinking, oh, well, I need to do a cloud like this because this is how. Maybe you watch one of my episodes and you're like, well, Jason painted a cloud like this, so I'm going to paint a cloud like this. But when I looked in the sky, the cloud was different. I saw shapes in it. I saw like a shape of a dragon in the cloud. But no one will believe me if I paint that cloud. They won't. They'll think it's I'm making it up. And they're one of the, it might be just me that thinks like that, actually. If you do think like that, just ignore that thought and just paint the way you saw it. So yeah, we had the cloud like that, and then there was some dark ones, and there was a dark one. It was sort of there, like that. Dark one there as well. There's like these dark, more straighter ones that kind of broke off from the main cloud. And there was these lot of wispy type light ones in the sky as well. Sort of like that. Just like wispy. Little wispy ones all over the place they were. It's almost like someone had been pushing the cloud around and split up a little bit like that. Something like that. Yeah, that's about right. Now I use my soft brush, my soft brush. Soft brush just to soften it. Like I've said before. Oh dear. What do you use a soft brush for? Ooh, I think it's to soften it, Jason. I think you're right. If you've never painted before, you wouldn't know that, would you? So. It's always best for me to explain it all. I feel like I want to soften the base of this cloud as well. Let the sky mix in a little
create a hole there. Don't like that hole there. The more you mist it away, the more it sort of blends. And then I'm going to come back with this colour. This colour. And add a bit of hardness to areas. Not all of it, just a couple of areas like that. Just sitting back. Having a look, trying to remember. It sort of came up like this there. Something like that. I think that was about like that. And now we want in some ground. I'm gonna get some of this yellow and throw it in with this. Let's have a look at that. A bit more of the yellow. I think it's the ground. Let's see if we're about right. That's not. That's more like it. Filling this in. But you see how this is all sort of looks light because of the dark cloud. I'm bringing this up. When you're blocking in colour and it starts to get to your arm, then just switch arms for a bit. I always do that. Just use my lefty. And then it's good training for your left arm as well. Make it work. Because painting and drawing is slightly different, so when I was teaching classes, I used to show people how to do mountains and things with my left as well as my right, because there's left-handed students there and they were struggling, so I taught myself to do it both ways to make it easier for people. So I can go, well, watch me do it. Now you can do it. Just want to show other people how to do it so then they can as well. And that's why I like doing these videos, really, because it shows you how to paint, how to do paintings, how to get you started at least. And then you can do some paintings, amazing paintings. I'm gonna get some black because there was a tree. Quite a lot of trees actually. And I'm thinking about it. Down along the horizon there's quite a lot of trees, but there was this biggest tree there. So let's get a bit of this black and then throw it in with our yellow. So what I want is a slightly different color. And we've got to think, when we use this colour on here, it's going to mix with that colour. A little bit. Let's go a little bit lighter. I'll try that. Do I use another brush or do I do the whole picture with this nice brush? I don't know. So let's put in some little tree shapes. tappy 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 tap tap tap. They're all the way up in the distance. If you want to use less paint, just tap your brush on your palette like that, and it will knock some of the paint off, and then you can do some. Oh, that was funny. Yeah. Because it left the big blotch of paint on the end. Never mind. I didn't want that tree to be too far away anyway. I'm going to make sure this works this time. Now use paper. So I'll get most of my paint off my brush. And now watch. There's hardly any paint. Hardly any paint. So you can put in a tree like that. I'm not keen on all that, so I'll lift that out a little bit with my brush. Just tapping it, really. Okay, so do a few more. Just using the corner of the brush and tapping. Thinking about all the trees on the horizon. I always forget how tall trees are. It's a weird thing to say, isn't it? But I do forget how big they are. It's not really light. Barely see that one. Something like that. I'm thinking, just using my memory banks, think about the tree that was there. There was quite a few trees on this bit. There's a few trees there, so I just tap on that. Okay, yeah, another field, I'll use some of this yellow. Field of like this, and there's a of a hedge that was going along there. The farmers, they like to split their field up. It goes off. And there's this tree, and it's right here. I might roll my brush. Just roll my brush like that, because it had loads of holes in it, and I remember thinking to myself, how am I going to get that kind of effect? And I thought, oh, if I roll my brush a little bit, then I'll be able to see through still. Something like this. And it looks really dark. Something like that. Use that. And then it's quite rough down here. Just gonna sort of roll my brush around a little bit. Try and make it a little effects. Some of this come off. Quite rough as it comes towards the road. It was all gnarly. The ground was all gnarly around there. Like we've been digging it or something with some machine. It's just all dug up and rough like that. Something like that. There wasn't one there, but I feel like I want to put another tree this side. Or something. I feel like there should be something. There should be something like there. There wasn't a tree there, so I shouldn't really put one in. I should really stick to what I saw, shouldn't I? Trying to fight the idea of painting what you see. I shouldn't be. In my mind, that was really dark there for some reason. On this side. I suppose the light is only on one side and it's hitting that over there. The hedge could do a darkening a touch and on there, couldn't it? Just make it a little bit bigger and then it goes off. Just wipe my brush. Wiping my brush. Okay, let's have a look. Yeah, and then I could see. These are little sticks and things. Where's my line of use a liner. Just grab all the brushes and look at them. And none of them is a liner. When you need one. What I might do, since I have no idea where my liner brush is, I'll scrape off some little lines. all these like little things growing in amongst that rough soil. Okay, and then I use my soft brush just to go over that a little bit. Make them disappear a little bit. Yeah, something like that. Yeah, that's pretty much what I saw this morning. So that's Oil Eye episode number three. Thanks very much for watching. If you'd like to support the channel, check out my Patreon page where you can support me for as little as $1 a month, or you can get a t-shirt or a mug with my mug on it. Or you can just share the videos and like and enjoy them. And if you're doing this challenge as well, and I hope you're doing well and enjoying it, because I'm really enjoying it actually. I'm really enjoying my painting. And so yeah, thanks very much for watching, and see you in another one. Cheers, bye.